Hey there, welcome back to yet another episode in the journey of demystifying the Patents Act. In this episode, we will be discussing about convention applications. This happens to be the most requested topic. Before we get into the details about the procedures, the requirements at the Indian Patent Office, let's recap what we discussed in one of the earlier episodes by going over this video. Now, if you recall, patent rights are territorial in nature. What does it mean? It means that you need to file an application in all the countries where all you seek protection. But at the same time, we also know that all the patent offices require your idea to have novelty and non-obviousness. Your idea needs to satisfy these two requirements along with others. Now, there could be a case where your own publications, your own products, or your own usage of the invention can be used against you for destroying the novelty. In such cases, if I were to file an application in other country and then come to India to file another application on the same idea because I want protection in India also, wouldn't that application be treated as prior art for me? Yeah, as ideally, yes. So it means I need to make application in all the countries where I need the protection at the same time, on the same day. Practically, it is a little challenging, if not possible. Don't you think so? So realizing this, countries came together and signed a treaty, which is known as Paris Convention Treaty. As per this treaty, it was decided that the member countries would provide same sort of rights and privileges to citizens of other member countries as well. Too complex, right? What it means is we will provide you with a grace period of 12 months to enter the other member countries from the first filing date. Taking the example here, let's say an application was filed in a convention country. That the convention country, the other member country basically, was the first one to receive an application for the idea. The person wants to enter with the Indian Patent Office now. So it has to enter within 12 months from the date on which it was filed in with the member country. Now it could be filed in one country, it could be filed in multiple countries, but all this has to be finished in 12 months as depicted in the picture. The forms remain the same. Whether it is ordinary or it's conventional application, the form remains the same. Everything has to be completed within 12 months with the same process requirements. We will discuss all of this in subsequent videos. Now, with that as background, let's start this episode by first discussing what are convention countries. So, as per Section 133, any country which is part or signatory of a treaty of which India is also part of are called convention countries. Now, it could be a country or group of countries or union of countries or intergovernmental organization, part of or signatories of treaties. Now, these treaties could be international, regional, bilateral, any convention or arrangement. Now, as part of these treaties, the member countries have agreed to provide similar rights and privileges to the citizens or applicants of other member countries. Now, similar privileges with regards to the grant of patents and protection of patent rights as they provide to their own citizens. Now, what about those countries that do not provide such like privileges? So, as per Section 134, citizens of such countries are not allowed to apply for an Indian patent or be named as assignee or proprietor of any Indian patent or application or take license under any Indian patent. So, tit for tat. So with this, we have enough information about what are convention countries and what are not. Let's learn about the timelines within which such convention application needs to be filed. As per Section 135.1, a convention application needs to be filed within 12 months from the first filing date. Now, this first filing is filing of the basic application in one of the convention countries, one of the member countries. Now, in case two or more applications were filed in two or more convention countries, member countries, then the 12 months are calculated from the earliest filing date. Similarly, priority date of such a convention application would be the earliest filing date in one of the convention application. Now, what if two or more inventions were filed in two or more convention countries, member countries? In such cases, as per section 135.2, one single convention application can be filed with Indian Patent Office claiming priority from these multiple filings, provided such inventions are cognate or modification of one another. Basically, they are similar inventions or same inventions. In such cases, within 12 months from the earliest filing date, one application combining all of these can be filed with Indian Patent Office. Fun fact regarding this, the fee that would be charged by the Indian Patent Office would be as if multiple applications were filed. Interesting, isn't it? Moving on to another interesting case, where as per section 135.3, where you had an Indian application, you took priority from an Indian application and filed a PCT application, international application. We'll discuss about PCT in the next video. And after that, you once again entered Indian Patent Office through the national phase. So you have two applications, one the basic application and another the national phase application, which you entered after 31 months from the earliest filing date. Now, what happens to these two applications? Which application gets forward? So you need to file a request for examination for one of these applications. Accordingly, one of these applications gets forwarded and another application gets abandoned. In the previous slide, we talked about claiming priority from multiple inventions or multiple applications. In such cases, how do we decide the priority date of a claim in the convention application that is filed with the Indian Patent Office? So as per section 137.1, when one application is getting filed by combining all these different applications in the member countries, then the priority date of the claim in the convention application is decided based on where the matter was first disclosed completely. We have discussed this during our discussion of priority dates of claims. Just a quick recap, if the claim is disclosed in one of them, then the priority date would be of that particular specification. If it is disclosed partly in one or more of them, then the latest one. In case the claim or subject matter was disclosed completely in each one of them, then the priority date is taken from the earliest filing date. We discussed this enough in the previous videos. Similar concept. So at this stage, we have understood the timelines and we have also understood how to establish priority date of each claim of such a convention application. So now, what are the requirements? So a convention application is also filed with the same forms, form 1, 2, 3, 5, and 26. So what are the special requirements? So as per section 136.1, a convention application has to be associated with a complete specification. No provisional specification is allowed for a convention application. And you are required to specify the date on which it was filed for the very first time in one of the convention countries. You also need to state that no application was filed before the date that you are specifying. More of a disclaimer that you are giving. Further, section 136.2 says that you are free to include claims in the convention application with regards to any addition or modification that might have happened to the original application that was filed in the convention countries. Of course, the priority date of the claim will be computed based on when it was first disclosed. One interesting aspect about convention application is you can post-date a convention application, but subject to ensuring that the 12 months of period from the basic application to the Indian filing doesn't get extended beyond 12 months. So post-dating is done under section 17. So section 136.3 talks about that the post-dating should be done subject to the 12 months period that needs to be maintained. So these are few peculiar details with regards to the convention application. Let's touch upon a few more as defined by Section 138. So as per Section 138.1, a controller may request you to provide copies of a specification that was filed in the convention country and any other document that you may have filed with the convention country. This has to be submitted within 3 months from the request made by the controller. Another requirement is that all the foreign language documents should be translated to English, and then duly certified copies should be submitted to the patent office as per Section 138.2. Now, since the convention applications are claiming priority from a filing date of the convention country, so there is this clarity that is provided by the patent office, which says that we will consider the date which is certified by the head of the patent office of such a country or date of filing as evident by the patent registered at the convention countries as per Section 138.3. Moving on, the section further provides few details with regards to PCT national phase applications. We'll discuss about it later on, but then Section 138 talks about it. First is specification or any other document filed with the PCT international application will be treated as the specification for the Indian national phase application as well, as per Section 138.4. Similarly, application date of the Indian national phase application will be the international filing date of the PCT application, as per Section 138.5. 138.6 talks about amendments. So any amendment to the PCT application that was done before International Search Authority or International Examination Authority would be treated as if the amendment were done before the Indian Patent Office as well. So these are few details come explanations with regards to convention applications or PCT national phase applications. Here are few interesting points about convention applications. Filing timelines, priority date, term of the patents for convention application. There could be a divisional application that can come out of the convention application. There could be a patent of addition that can come out of the convention application. And remember, convention applications have to be accompanied by a complete specification. No provisional application with regards to convention applications. So this brings us to the end of this episode. In the next episode, we will discuss about the PCT application, the national phase applications as requested by many of you, the ISAs, the IPEAs, the filing deadlines and specific requirements with regards to the Indian Patent Office. So have some patience. I'll be out with that video in next few days. Take care. Bye-bye.